पर ही बैठा, जहां पर नंद बाबा अपने गोपों के साथ बैठकर विचार परामर्श करते हैं, अब क्या करेंगे, गायों के साथ कैसे करना है, अगले वर्ष क्या करना है, ये पहली बातें सब बैठाकर बातचीत करते हैं। आज सभी ब्रजवासियों ने कहा कि बाबा हमको आपसे बहुत महत्वपूर्ण कुछ बात करनी है। तो बैठान में आए, जहां पर सभी बड़े बूढ़े गोप बैठे और नंद बाबा, वो तो ब्रजराज हैं, बड़े सुंदर वस्त्र धारण करके, अलंकार धारण करके, कुंडल धारण करके, मोतियों की माला, चरणों में कड़वा, हाथों में कंगन, बगल बंदी धारण करके, सफेद पाग, उस पर मोतियों की माला झलक रही है। इस रूप में श्री नंद बाबा वहां विराजमान हुए। अच्छा कहो कहो, क्या विचार परामर्श है, किस बात की मीटिंग है, क्या विचार करना है। तब गोपों ने एक बात कही, बोलते बाबा एक बात कही, आपका जो लाला है ना, आपका जो पुत्र है ना कन्हैया, ये कोई साधारण वाला
Krishna is not an ordinary child. So when Nand Maharaj heard that the Brajvasis consider Krishna as Bhagavan, Nand Maharaj, he started laughing. Chal raha hai na? Theek hai. In Vrindavan when we go, and all the pandas, they make everybody laugh in Braj. So they laugh, like the why do they make us laugh? Because when we go back to our homes, we cry. So those who do not laugh in Braj. So Baba, he laughed so loudly that your gopas, looks like there's something wrong with you. You think that Krishna is Supreme Personality. He is just an ordinary child, a very small child of mine. Kwa sapta hai na bala. It is mentioned that where that that Giriraj Govardhan is so huge, and he lifted Shri Giriraj Govardhan for 7 continuous days. Why won't we? In fact, we are doubtful that he is your child. He is Ishwar. He is Lord himself. You yourself saw that he lifted Giriraj Govardhan. An ordinary child cannot lift such big mountain, such big hill. So he must be Bhagavan. Then Shri Nand Maharaj, he revealed to the Brajvasis that it's not your fault that you consider Krishna to be Supreme Personality. Because when he came, so when the Namkaran Leela of Krishna was performed, Shri Gargacharya, he said, that sometimes Lord Narayan's potency would enter into your son. And when the qualities of Narayan would enter into his body, then he would perform miraculous activities. Don't be fearful. Don't think. Don't be fearful when he performs such pastimes. It is the mercy of Sri Narayan that this boy performs miraculous activities. The coward men, they said, when did this Namkaran Leela, this name giving ceremony took place? And Maharaj was like, oh. He said, this name giving ceremony happened in secretly in the Gaushala, that's why you don't know. So all the gopas were listening to this. Mr. Krishna was thinking that though I have given protection to the Brajvasis, and now the biggest calamity, biggest trouble will fall upon me if it is proven that I am Supreme Personality. Krishna was thinking like this, that what would these Brajvasis do? They would make a wooden box, they would put me in that box, give me some sweets, and would apply a Panditji to offer puja. I don't want to become the Lord. In Braj, I just want to play with the Gopa. This is what Krishna was thinking in his mind, that if the Brajvasis think that I am Supreme Personality, and if it is proven today, Krishna was also thinking, oh, he was also fearful, he was also anxious. But when Nand Maharaj said, no, he is not Supreme Personality, but the qualities of Narayan enters in your son. So not only Nand Maharaj, all the gopas, they also laughed. Not only Nand Maharaj, but all the gopas, they laughed. Now the Brajvasis is like, oh, now we know why he performs such miraculous activities from nowhere. He kills so many demons, lifts Giriraj Govardhan. Now we got to know. Had you told us before, we would not have any doubts. Now we know that he lies, he steals, and many complaints are being made, very restless, and we would think, how can he be Lord? But then when he would perform such pastimes, we would be doubtful. But Gargacharya says, Narayan Sameguna, that he has more qualities than Sri Narayan. This is what Sri Gargacharya said. Nand Maharaj understood from his point. When Gargacharya, he said that the qualities of Krishna would be more than the qualities of Sri Narayan. But Sri Nand Maharaj understands from his side, from his mood, that the qualities of Narayan would enter. Now, if we see, Lord Narayan has 60 qualities. In jivas, in the material jivas, there are 50 jivas and 18 faults. Yesterday I mentioned the 18 faults. In devatas, there are 55 qualities. And all the avatars, they have 60 qualities. But only Sri Krishna has extra 4 qualities. Not in any other avatar, these 4 qualities are there. And in these 4 qualities, the entire Leela of Braj is included. And these 4 qualities are सर्व अद्भुत चमत्कार लीला कल्लोल वाहिनी. Understand these 4 qualities. The 4 extra qualities than Sri Narayan. First is Leela Madhuri. Second is Venu Madhuri. the sweetness of his flute, and third is the sweetness of his beauty, and the fourth is Premadri, the sweetness of his prema. If I start explaining these four things, then it will take another 3 to 4 days. The leelas of Krishna cannot be compared to any other avatar, where there's so much of meeting and so much of separation. In Ramji's pastimes, there is meeting and separation, but it is limited. But in Krishna's pastimes, the separation in Krishna's pastime is the highest. Because amongst all the leelas, Ras Leela is the topmost. Did Sri Ramji perform Ras Leela? Bhagavan Narasimhadev, he performed Ras Leela? Any other avatar, Sri Narayan, none of them. Who performed Ras Leela? Krishna. Only Krishna, he performed Ras Leela with 1 billion gopis. Krishna is dancing with 1 billion gopis alone. How is he performing this last time? That's what Shukdev Goswami Pad says, Bhagavan Api, he is Bhagavan. So one should not be astonished. It's not an ordinary child or ordinary boy. How can one perform Ras Leela with 1 billion gopis? So amongst all the leelas, Ras Leela is the topmost. Shri Krishna was asked, Hey Prabhu, amongst all of your pastimes, which pastimes are the most attracted to you? Janis Mithirase. Tired. Feverish. Krishna himself says that when I remember Ras Leela, I don't know, something happens to me. There are many pastimes, but this Ras Leela pastimes is the most attractive to me. That Ras Leela took place in Mathura, in Ayodhya, in Srirangam. Should I turn off the fan? Okay. This Ras cannot take place anywhere else except Sri Vrindavan. Rasa samoha iti rasaha. Sri Madhavji likes Sri Ras Leela the most. The meaning of Ras is rasa. What is the meaning of rasa? When we make a lemonade, we put water, sugar, salt, black pepper. When we mix so many things, it is rasa. So in Ras, the four ingredients are very important. Second is heroine, Nayaka. Third is Sahachari. Nayak means hero. Ban kar do. Dhakka maar. So Nayika is the heroine. But in the cultured language, it's Nayika. And who is that? That is Sri Radhika. In order to give pleasure to the Radha and Krishna, there are Brajdevis, the Sahacharis. All the Brajdevis are Sahacharis. But the point which I have raised today, the subject, the most is, this is a very important ingredient. If that is not there, then Ras cannot take place. And that is, just like a mother makes very nice prasad, but if she forgets to add salt, the most cheapest, if she does not put any salt, then the food is tasteless. Similarly, if there are all the ingredients, even if Krishna is there, Radhika is there, and gopis are there, the most important ingredient is, and that can happen only in Vrindavan. If there is no Vrindavan, then Ras cannot take place. Because the gopis, Krishna and Radhika, all of them were there in Kurukshetra also. Then Krishna said, can we perform Ras Leela here? Sri Radhika said, no, Ras cannot be performed here. So Vrindavan is the most important ingredient. So amongst all the pastimes, Sri Ras Leela is topmost. It's also known as Prem Leela. Krishna's form is like fresh rain clouds. Three places Krishna's beauty is being spoken or is being mentioned. Mm-hmm. Now the question comes that Krishna is wearing Pitambar. Why is Krishna black? We see, why do we hear Krishna is black when it's mentioned clearly that he is of a bluish complexion? What was I saying? Why Krishna is black? Why is Krishna is black? Why Radhika is gaur, fair, white? There must be a reason behind that. Rupa Goswami Pad is saying this. In Braj there are four rasas. You may not be able to understand because it's Siddhanta. Simple pastimes are understood and likened by everybody, but you would not find such things in the television. This is Gaudiya Siddhanta. Tomorrow if anyone asks you, so you worship Radha Krishna all the time. Don't you know why Krishna is blackish or bluish? Why? Why Radhika is fair? Why? Why she is like molten gold? What would we say? No, they're just like that. Well, we must know the answer. So there must be a reason behind all this. But what is the reason behind their color, their complexion? In Vrindavan there are four rasas. Dasya, Sakya, Vatsalya and Madhuri. Some
और एक रसिया वास्तव यशोदा मैया नंद बाबा उनके माता पिता हैं.
Nand Maharaj and Mother Yashoda, they serve him as their mother and father. Fourth is the gopis. Just like in this world, there are servants in the house, then there are friends, then the mother and father and the relationship. So everybody has same type of relationship. But then, so if you see someone's eyes, so some are friends who are very close, they understand everything going on in the heart. Similarly, Krishna's one friend is Arjun. They eat together, sleep on the same bed. Such an intimate relationship. And Krishna even rides the chariot of Arjuna, makes Arjuna sit behind him, and he becomes a charioteer. Such close relationship. And Gita ji, he said, Priyosi, may you're very, very dear to me. But in Kurukshetra, in the battlefield, when Krishna showed his universal form, when Arjuna raised his hands, he said, oh, hey Prabhu, hey Krishna, please forgive me. I used to say to Yadav, Krishna, I would address you like this. In fact, I would give you the orders. Now when we saw the Virat form, then Satyaras and loving relationship, it was subdued. Krishna was like, oh. So Arjuna is one of the friends of Krishna, but they're not that close. This one friend is Uddhavji. Krishna's the Daita Sakha. Uddhavji is also very, very dear to Krishna. Krishna reveals his heart to Shri Uddhav ji. He is not telling this to Arjuna. What he is saying? He shared the confidential moods of his in regards to the gopis. He never said to Arjuna to go and pacify the gopis, but he sent Arjun. Arjun had so much of love and affection for Krishna, very intimate, but then all of a sudden he saw the universal form, he started paying pranams to him. So the mood was changed. If you have a friend, let's say if you have a friend, and then you go to somewhere, and there, and then you don't know what is the business of your friend. And then you had a nice time with your friend, and they come back to home. And when that friend of yours came at your house, he was like, oh, he was astonished. Because in the hotel, we didn't know. Now we got to know he's a very big businessman. So 5,000 employees, they work here. So I didn't know when I was roaming with him. So now, when the opulence is revealed, the mood has changed. So Bhagwan does not like this. So Arjuna, Uddhavji is very, very close to Krishna, because Krishna shares his heart with Shri Uddhavji. In relationship to Shri Uddhavji, it is mentioned Vishni Naam Param Mantri. He is the topmost amongst all the advisors of Krishna. Krishna Siddhaitsaka, very, very dear friend of Krishna. Very dear, very close friend of Krishna, Shri Uddhavji. And then he is the direct disciple of Shri Brihaspati. Uddhavji is very sharp-minded. Uddhavji is very sharp-minded. So Bhagavan is revealing his mind to his friends. So when Krishna went to to Mathura, I'm not taking Bhagavan to Mathura, but now, since I'm speaking about this, I'll talk. Our Radha Madhava is still in Braj. We're not going to Mathura, but in connection with what I'm speaking now, I'll be talking a little bit about Mathura. Krishna went to Mathura. Bhagavan was remembering the Braj Devis. He was remembering his mother and father. Listen very carefully. Who can go to Braj and pacify my mother and father? Who can pacify the gopis? But with whom I can share my heart? So while he was thinking like this, in Mathura, who would understand my mood? He was thinking like this. So he saw Shri Uddhavji. So this is the one, this is the person with whom I can share my heart. He is the one who I can send to Mathura. Why? With those who know my opulence, and that person who is aware of my sweetness and also is aware of my Leela, I will send that person. Why? Are you able to understand what I am saying? When Krishna was 10 years, 2 months old, he left Gokul, went to Mathura and killed Kansa. Now he is remembering that how he can pacify his mother and father who are living in Braj. How can he pacify the gopis? Krishna is thinking like this because he cannot go back. Why he can't go back? Is if I go there, then the demons would start attacking Brajmandal. And my Brajvasis do not have any weapons to fight with. And if any one of them suffers anything because of me, then I am going to destroy the entire creation. My life remains in the Brajvasis. If anything happens to them because of me, I am going to destroy the entire creation. So I am not going by myself. So I want to send someone who can pacify them. But he is thinking that who to send? Krishna is thinking. Not like to send anyone. Krishna was thinking, a person who knows my opulence, who knows my sweetness, and who also knows my Leela. Why? If I send someone who is not aware of my opulence, then he would keep on speaking and would not understand that the Brajvasis do not know my opulence. And my Brajvasis don't even consider anything about my opulence. They would not understand anything. If I send something who only knows my sweetness, then Brajvasis are crying in my sweetness anyways. So who would pacify them? Krishna is thinking very carefully who to send. Therefore, who is the one who knows the opulence and the sweetness of mine? Why? Because Shri Uddhavji, he knows the opulence of Bhagavan. Shri Krishna places his feet and many great personalities, they come and pay pranams at his lotus feet. This is what Uddhavji has seen. Kirat Koti Yadapada Peetam. This was just like one time Shri Brahmaji, that if I do not create, that who will do it? I am the one who is the creator. So Lord never makes anyone clap for me. Lord never praises me. Today, I am going to go on a strike and see who is going to help him in creating this material world. So he came to Dwarka. In fact, he came to Dwarka to complain. He said, He said, you don't even make me become, don't even praise me in front of anyone. So Brahmaji came to Dwarka. He was saying to the gatekeepers that I, Brahma, has come to see you. Lord knows everything. He knows the heart of everybody. And Krishna said, ask which Brahma has come. The Dwarpal were like, which Brahma? Brahmaji was like, which Brahma? What do you mean? When it was asked, which Brahma? Brahmaji was thinking, oh, he said, I'm the only Brahma, four-headed Brahma. I'm the only Brahma. The gatekeepers, they went to Krishna and Dwarkadhish Krishna. He called out to all the Brahmas, and all the Brahmas, they came from their own various planets, from various Brahmands, and Shri Krishna, Krishna Sabha, his assembly, it is known as Sudharma Sabha. It is so magical that the hall would decrease if four seats are required, and if 400,000 people seats are required, it would expand. So all the Brahmas from various Brahmands, they all came, universes, they came. riding on the swan, the chariot, the carrier. And Krishna said, okay, send the four-headed Brahma inside. So the gatekeeper said, please go inside. Lord is calling you. He went inside thinking that he is going to complain. So Brahmaji, when he came inside, he saw Krishna was sitting on this big asan, big throne. And he saw that he saw a 10-headed Brahma. And then he saw a 100-headed Brahma. The 1,000-headed Brahma. He was absolutely perplexed. Then he saw 10,000-headed Brahma. Then he saw many other Brahmajis in the same assembly. He saw many Brahmas there with lakhs and lakhs of heads. He was thinking, oh, I'm the smallest one. Everybody is bigger than me. Brahmaji was sweating and he came and paid pranams to the Lord. Krishna said, Brahmaji, did you come here to say something? Brahmaji said, I just came to have a darshan, nothing else. It's been long, I haven't seen you. So Brahmaji did not reveal why he came. Because he was feeling, he was having this pride that I am the creator. But then he saw so many other Brahmas there. The pride was crushed. And that place where Krishna places his feet, and Brahmajis and many Brahmas, they are putting their crown, and the sound of thun, because those crowns are made of gold or various other metals. So Uddhavji had seen all this. This is the opulence of Bhagavan. Who is saying this? Sri Uddhavji is saying this. Uddhavji also knows the sweetness of Krishna. Krishna's beauty has a natural attraction that it makes the man or women both becomes restless, become attracted. That is the nature of Krishna's Bhagavan. Not like us, men and women. Here, Nari means Sri Lakshmiji. Even Lakshmiji, she becomes attracted towards Krishna, who has gone to Vrindavan. Everybody raise hands. If you cross Yamuna, there's a place called Belvan. Now, very less people, but people think about Vrindavan. Bihari ji, Shri Banki Bihari Mandir means Vrindavan. Some people said Mandir where you eat tikkis, aloo tikki. Go to Bihari ji, so much of pushing. Phones are stolen, and then nice aloo tikki, lassi, Bihari Lal ki jai. Sunday program hai, theek hai na? Is Sunday, haan. Bihari ji's darshan, you just go and have darshan of Shri Bihari ji. It's seeing Bihari ji, not darshan. When we through eyes we can see, and when we hear, it is darshan. We have seen, but then we haven't had darshan. Darshan means when we sit near a sadhu and we hear Srimad Bhagavatam, that's when we have darshan.
Nazar to ye nagar jayegi shaam.
मेरे काके बिहारी मेरे काके बिहारी इतना ना करी हो शेखा नजर तो है लग जाएगी श्यामा नजर तो है लग जाएगी ये होता है कारण से
वो कहाँ पर है मुझे
So Bhagwan showed such a beautiful form that even Lakshmi Rishi became enchanted. Shri Lakshmi Ji, who stays with Shri Narayan, she serves Shri Narayan. And when she had darshan of Krishna's form, even that Lakshmi developed a desire to perform Ras Leela, that I want to attain you. Therefore, in Belvan, she is performing austerities. She is performing tapasya in Belvan, austerities in Belvan. So, even the Naris, the Lakshmis, they become attracted. And what is Nara? Mahavishnu, the Bhoma Purush, he becomes enchanted. In Dwarka, there is a pastime which took place. In Dwarka, there is a Brahman. In Dwarka, there is a Brahman.
बालक होता और साथ ही साथ मर
जाता। देखो जब ब्राह्मण इन द्वार का
कृष्ण को दोष देने लगा, बोले हमारे राजा कृष्ण हैं, देखो प्रजा कितनी परेशान हो रही है।
So there was a Brahman who would become a father, and the son would die, and it would happen multiple times. So Arjuna said, "This is not because of Krishna." He said, "Why it's happening?" He said, "Many sons of mine, they take birth and die. Why it's happening?" And Arjuna said, "When now next time you become a father, I'm going to make a cage." That even death would not be able to enter into that cage. Then Brahmani, the wife, when she was about to give birth and a child was born, then Brahman called Arjun, and Arjuna made a cage of arrows that even death was not able to enter. But this time, the child was born, there was no body, and the body was gone. It disappeared. Then Brahman was cursing Arjuna. He said, "You and your master both are the same." And Arjuna was thinking, "Why it's happening?" Then he went to the Lord. He said, "Prabhu, why is this happening?" Then Krishna said, "I know why it's happening." Then they went to Shri Mahavishnu Loka. That Vishnu said, "I'm the one who is stealing the boys of this Brahman." He said, "Why are you stealing the boys of the Brahman?" Because I wanted to see you. Because I knew that one day you will come to give me your darshan. So I would steal the Brahman boys to see your form, because I know one day you will come to bring all of them back." So Lakshmi Ji is being enchanted. Shri Vishnu Ji is also enchanted. Even Krishna himself, he sees his own form in the pillar, and he becomes enchanted. And Krishna says to the pillar, "Who is more beautiful than me? Who are you? I feel like I should embrace you." You're so beautiful. He's seeing his own form in the pillar, in the reflection, and he wants to embrace his own, he wants to relish his own form. So Krishna is unable to understand his sweetness. That's why he comes as Srimad Mahaprabhu and tastes his own form. Therefore, Sri Uddhavji is the one who understands Krishna's sweetness and also Krishna's opulence. Also understands Krishna's Leela. Gopa Gopya Alankrita. He said, Uddhavji, go to Braj. Uddhavji, go to Braj. And my mother and father, who are feeling separation from me, go there and pacify them. But only give my message to them. Do not try to say anything from your side. So Uddhavji came to Braj. This is a very detailed pastime. I'm going to speak in a brief manner. Today is the last day of Srimad Bhagavatam. So I'll just touch upon certain points. If it would take many hours to speak these pastimes, only this pastime. Uddhavji came to Braj. Everything is very dry. The calves, they never leave the mother in general. But now the calves are being forced by the cowherd men to drink milk. The cows, they never stop drinking the grass. But they are pushing the cows to eat the grass. The birds, the parrots, everybody is crying. Then Uddhavji said, I'm unable to see anyone here. It's absolutely deserted. He saw someone. He said, please stop. I want to know where is the house of Srinanda Maharaj. He said, have you come here for the first time? He said, yes. He said, you see this stream of water. Just follow this. Where it stops, that is Srinanda Maharaj's house. He said, I'm unable to understand. He said, you've come new. That's why you don't know. This stream of water which is coming, since Krishna has left Braja, Srinanda Maharaji, his house, everybody cries. Nanda Maharaja, he cries. Sri Yashoda Maya, she cries. And all the Brajvasis, they cry. And then the tears of theirs have turned into this stream of water. So Uddhavji was thinking, why are they crying so much? When he went inside, and Nanda Maharaj saw Uddhavji, and at first instance, Sri Nanda Maharaj thought it was Krishna. Because Uddhavji was wearing the clothes of Krishna. And Krishna's Uddhavji's color was also like Krishna's. And he would also wear the garland of Krishna. Because Uddhavji is that if one wants to overcome Maya, then it can only happen by the prasad of Krishna. Therefore, seeing Sri Uddhavji, for an instance, Sri Nanda Maharaj, he thought, that's Krishna. But then he said, oh, no, that's not the fragrance of Krishna. Nanda Maharaj was able to differentiate. He said, oh, that's Uddhavji, please come. Nanda Maharaj offered him the seat. So everything is fine in Mathura? How is Sri Ugrasen Maharaj? How is Sri Devki ji? How is Vasudev ji? He was asking everyone's names. In fact, he wanted to ask, how is Krishna? But then, he didn't want to say the name of Krishna because his voice would choke. Tears started flowing from his eyes. Uddhav ji was thinking, hey Baba, why do you have to cry so much? Those who cry for Bhagavan, it's a matter of great fortune for them. He said, oh, everybody comes here and says, Krishna is Bhagavan, Krishna is Bhagavan. You're not the first one who is coming and saying that Krishna is Bhagavan. And Baba was thinking, everybody comes here and says, Krishna is Bhagavan, Krishna is Bhagavan. Nanda Maharaj is saying that when I go to Yamunaji, there I remember Krishna's pastimes. All the Braj reminds me of his pastimes. This is the same place where he would play with the friend, with his friends, and I become more restless. That he was thinking, first Uddhavji said it's a great fortune that if anyone cries for the Lord, is very fortunate, but then he cannot say you should cry more. So Uddhavji was unable to ascertain what to say. Should he keep on crying for the Lord or should he stop crying? Very beautiful conversation. And Nanda Maharaj was able to answer all questions of Shuddhavji. There's a more time is needed to explain this pastime. So the whole night passed by, and Mother Yashoda was unable to say anything or even speak anything. And all night passed by. He came to pacify them, but instead of that, Sri Nanda Maharaj, he started crying even more. Then Sri Uddhavji, he went to Yamunaji to take bath in Brahma Murat. There, when he went to Sri Yamunaji, he saw Sri, generally the lotus is very, very soft and very cold, but there was separation which was coming from the body of Sri Radhika. Then a bumblebee came there and came to have darshan of Sri Radhika's lotus feet, because the bumblebee only hovers around the lotus feet and tries to touch the lotus feet of Sri Radhika. And Radhaji was thinking, hey Matukitava Bandho, hey Brahmar, have you come here to increase the fire of separation even more? Many things Sri Radhika said, the entire Brahmar Gita can be spoken. I was speaking Braj Leela, and in that Braj Leela, these five important songs of Bhagavatam, one of them is Brahmar Gita. Sri Radhika said that all those who are black, they cannot be trusted. All of them, they lie, they're cheaters. Just like in Vidyala, just like in the school, when one learns from the teacher, then the students, they learn from the teacher and they leave. Just like the birds, they eat fruits from the trees and then they leave the tree. Many, many examples were given. Similarly, Krishna, he left us. All these black people are the same. So there's someone, एंड देयर वाज वन पर्सन हु वाज अ ब्लैक फेलो हु केम ही किल्ड बाली फ्रॉम द बैक इज दिस गुड killed a monkey from the back. Even a hunter does not kill anyone from the back. And the same black person who came, he cut the nose and ear of Shurpanakha. Is this good? No. What's her fault? You're so beautiful. If she became attracted to you, what is the problem in that? It is your fault. But should you do this? So Shri Uddhav Ji was thinking that Ram Ji is Kshatriya. He came in the sacrifice of Bali Maharaj with two lotus, with small lotus feet, took the form of Vamandev, and then he expanded his form and turned into the Trivikram and took everything away from Bali Maharaj. So Sri Radhika Ji is telling all these things that one should not trust any of these black personalities. Since I have come, Uddhav Ji said, since I have come, you are saying one should not trust these black fellows, but then you are constantly talking about him. Why not talk about anything else? Then Sri Radhika said, oh, this is our problem. That's our problem. That we can do everything and anything, but we cannot stop talking about him. Because his katha is like a nectar. We can give up our lives, but we are unable to give up our lives. Uddhav Ji was like, then give up your body then, if you're crying so much, give up your body, that's easy. Then Sri Radhika said, how can I give up my body? Because our lives, our ears have heard Krishna's katha. Now we cannot even give up this life. That person has tasted nectar. And if one has tasted nectar, we cannot die. Our mind is being stolen by Krishna. He left our life here behind. Then Uddhav Ji said, then you can be in the world with your body and senses. Gopis are like, that's not possible. Uddhav Ji came to Braj and revealed his heart only to Sri Uddhav Ji, who came to Braj to pacify the gopis. When Sri Uddhav Ji saw this, Uddhav Ji, who is the topmost of scholars or knowledgeable, he prayed to receive the lotus feet, the dust of the lotus feet of Sri Radhika. Padarenu Abhikshansha Yasam Hari. Uddhav Ji said, I want to receive just one single dust particle of Sri Radhika's lotus feet. Such a great scholar, and he is desiring to attain one dust particle of Sri Radhika. This is the glories of Braj. This is the glories of Sri Radhika. What does it show? That what happened when he came to Braj, who is higher, Krishna or Uddhav Ji is so knowledgeable. Is he the higher? No. Who is higher? Sri Radhika's dust is the higher. In Braj, everybody comes and desires the dust of Sri Radhika. Who has gone to Barsana here? Such high hill. Everybody just rides on their cars to go on top. But there's such huge mountain, Brahmaji himself has taken the form. So we pay pranams to Brahmaji first, because we are. Brahmaji has taken the form of the mountain. Why? In order to receive the dust particle of Sri Radhika. So that is Brahmaji. Where Naraji is performing austerities in Govardhan to attain one dust particle of Sri Radhika, became a blade of grass. Sri Uddhavji and Sri Naraji at Naradgunda, he is performing austerities. Uddhavji has become a, and Uddhavji has also become a blade of grass at Kusum Sarovar. where Shivji is speaking the glories of Radhika and seeking one sidelong glance of Sri Radhika's mercy. This is the glories of Sri Radhika. This is the essence of Srimad Bhagavatam. Sri Uddhavji, who is so dear to Krishna, so intimate, knows the heart of Krishna, understands Krishna's opulence, sweetness, leela, everything. He came to the conclusion that the highest benediction, the highest goal of anyone in this, all the three universe, all the three worlds, should be to attain one dust particle. This is called Bhagavat Shravan. Hearing Bhagavatam from Vaishnavas, especially from Gaudiya Vaishnavas, those who understand the essence of Srimad Bhagavatam. Else, many people say that there is no name of Radhika is mentioned in Sri Radhika. That there is no Radha in Sri Radhika or in Srimad Bhagavatam. In fact, Radharani's name is filled. In every page of Srimad Bhagavatam, you would find the glories of Sri Radhika. So this is Srimad Bhagavatam. This is the essence. Today we'll just talk about the essence. Why? Because a lot of things are to be spoken.
Thank you. गोपियों के लिए दर्ज कह रही है तन मन जीवन श्याम का श्याम हमारा का
तन मन जीवन श्याम का श्याम हमारा का
रोम रोम में बस रहा वो मत बाला
रोम रोम में बस रहा
वो मत बाला श्याम सिंधन में अब योग का सिंधन में अब योग का कोई ही पाना
है की है, कहें वो तो ज्ञान की गोदी में खड़ा होना है। रुद्र ने बताया ना हमारे दर्शन तो केवल प्रेम प्रेम के द्वारा ही सिद्धार्थ जी को वसुदूर करवाता है। यदि है उधो हा प्रेम डोर से बंध रहा जीवन का सहयोग,
जिन जगम
श्याम ले लाए
जिनका सर्वस्व श्री कृष्ण ही है और कृष्ण को छोड़कर वे और किसी को कुछ नहीं जानते, इसी भाव को देने के लिए
श्रीमद् महाप्रभु जी केम टू गिव दिस मूड अराउंड 500 इयर्स अगो, अराउंड 530 इयर्स अगो इन नदिया इन श्री नवद्वीप इन श्री मायापुर धाम ही केम एज द सन ऑफ श्री शशि माता By taking the moods of Sri Radhika, though he is Krishna, he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. In Bhagavad Gita, he gave many, many instructions. But he was thinking that I have given many instructions, but I haven't practiced by myself. I've spoken that gave up all religions, but come and take my shelter. But I myself have not showed it by my own example. So that same Krishna says to Radhika, that Hey Radha, Hey Shri Radhika, I'm unable to repay the depth of your prema. Radhika prem guri jar balite nahi paaye. राधा जी का प्रेम the prema of Sri Radhika, which constantly expands and increases. It never stops. There is no halt. Shri Krishna is thinking. Shri Madhavji, he thinks that there's a possibility that this prema, the expansion of this prema, will stop. And he tries very hard to reach that end. But Radharani's prema is constantly expanding every second. And Krishna is unable to find any end to it. And what is that prema? Krishna wants to relish that prema. And then he wants to give the beauty of that prema. And he wants to distribute the beauty of that prema to everybody in the world. Therefore, that same Krishna prays to Sri Radhika. He says, "Hey Radhike, first I am unable to repay the depth of your prema. I am able to reciprocate with everybody. I reciprocate with everybody. I exchange love on the basis of as per the reciprocation." So Krishna says, "I am unable to repay you your prema. It's in front of you. I bow down my head. Not only bow down my head, I place my vanshi and also peacock feather at your lotus feet. This is the glories of Sri Vrindavan. This is real Vrindavan. Leave everything aside. Even Madhav himself, he is paying pranams at the lotus feet, bowing down his head at the lotus feet of Sri Radhika. Even great writers like Sri Jayadev Goswami is unable to write such things. But that Krishna, Smaragar Mandehi Pada Pallava Mudaram, Sri Jayadev Goswami is writing that Krishna himself is paying pranams at the lotus feet of Sri Radhika. But then if one borrows money from someone, then one needs to pay it back. Krishna is thinking how to repay Sri Radhika. So in this Kali Yuga, 540 years ago, that same Krishna comes as Sriman Mahaprabhu. And he becomes absorbed in the mood of Sri Radhika and relishing this name. Which name? He's relishing his own name along with his associates, his devotees. In the morning, when the moment the sun rises in the morning, and then there is a redness appears in the sky, Mahaprabhuji along with his associates. Purab Purab Bhage Dvijamani Gaur Amani Jage. Along with his association, Mahaprabhu is raised hands. He starts off Sri Harinam Sankirtan. Which Mahaprabhu? That same Mahaprabhu, that same Krishna, when he is totally combined with Sri Radhika, and then comes as Sriman Mahaprabhu. And sings Nam Sankirtan. Mahaprabhu is singing this Maha Mantra, brought this from the spiritual planet. This Maha Mantra, when you and all of us sing, and those who don't chant this must be encouraged to chant. It's a wealth of Sri Golok Vrindavan. And Sriman Mahaprabhu, Krishna, in form of Sriman Mahaprabhu, brought that wealth here. Mahaprabhu is saying, everybody is suffering from a disease, not like cancer, not COVID or Corona. Everybody is suffering from a disease of birth and death. One becomes sick, one becomes old, and then one dies. And lifetimes pass by. So we're constantly going through these birth, death, disease, and old age. So, hey bhaiyo, my brothers, I brought a very special medicine from Golok Vrindavan. And what is that? Harinam Mahamantra. This is the name of Shri, or name of the Lord. On one hand, this is medicine. On the other hand, it's mentioned Harinam Sankirtan. This is Premdhan. On one hand, it's mentioned as it's medicine, on the other hand, it's mentioned. At another place, it's mentioned as Premdhan. So, the highest wealth of Sri Radha Krishna's Golok Vrindavan is the name, where Krishna's in separation from Sri Radhika calls out the name of Sri Radhika, and Radhika in separation from Krishna calls out the name of Krishna. Then Krishna says Hare in separation of Krishna, of Sri Radhika. That someone who steals the mind of Krishna, the heart of Krishna, and Krishna says Hare, and Sri Radhika says Krishna in separation, Sarva Akarsha Karoti Iti Krishna, that you attract everybody towards me. That, hey Krishna, please give me your darshan. And when they meet together, Radhaji, she becomes so anxious, and she says, Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. And Krishna says, Hare, Hare, means Radhe, Radhe. Therefore, this is the wealth of Sri Golok. This is the wealth of Sri Golok Vrindavan, not ordinary. When Radha and Madhav, they get together and distribute this prema, not thinking about anything and just distributing this prema, not thinking one is beautiful or ugly, one is Brahman or Shudra, one is human or an animal, rich or poor, no consideration is being made. So Mahaprabhu distributed that prema to everybody. And to attain that prema is the greatest wealth or the greatest goal. Amongst all the jivas have one dharma. Hindu, Muslim, these are not dharmas. These are various paths. But everybody is. A jiva is not a Hindu or a Christian. A jiva is not a Muslim. A jiva is not a Jain. Jivatma is, soul is, soul does not have, soul is not man and woman. We are the servants. And lifetimes pass by to attain that prema. It generally takes lifetimes, even lakhs and lakhs of times pass by. Lifetimes pass by. In order to reduce the process, Sriman Mahaprabhu, he came and gave us a very straightforward path. If anyone would chant this name, if one is able to chant the name, and if anyone would chant this name properly, then Mahaprabhu says, I give the guarantee. Iti shodashitnamna kali kalmashnanasham, that all the sins of Kali, all the various sufferings of Kali, of Kali Yuga would be totally demolished or destroyed. Naam is the greatest purification. Naam is the greatest worship. Naam is the greatest mantra. There's nothing which is more higher than the name. that name is everything. So that Radha Madhav has appeared in form of the name. So anyone can chant those names under any circumstance. Therefore it's mentioned, the straightforward path, if one wants to deliver oneself for peacefulness, for perfection, that Harir Naam, Naam, Harir Naam, Aiva Kevalam. Aiva means that's it. Aiva Kevalam, as Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying. Naaste Gatirannatha. Nothing here. This is the only name. Only Harinam is the actual wealth. So anyone who has accepted this Harinam, one would attain this Braj Bhav. Even one hears high pastimes, one may attain impression, but until one takes shelter of the holy name, that Harikatha would not stay in the heart. So if you really want to receive this deeper impression, and the Lord Himself is begging, please take this name. If anyone wants to take this name, they can. Mahaprabhu is distributing this love of Godhead to everybody through the holy name, through His associates and Himself, Mahaprabhu Himself, going from door to door. And there's a very nearest associate of Srimad Mahaprabhu is our Srila Gurudev and our Guru Parampara, who are completely wealthy in the holy name. So if we don't chant the name, what would we attain? The essence of everything is Sri Naam. Bhagavati's essence is Sri Naam. Sankirtane vayasya sarva papa pranashanam pranamam dukkha shamanam tam namami hari param. The last shloka of Srimad Bhagavatam. This is the essence of Srimad Bhagavatam at the Naam Sankirtanayasya. There's nothing which is more higher than the name. Therefore, Srimad Mahaprabhuji, he is requesting everybody. He is Lord Himself and saying to the Jivas, hey Jivas, requesting the Jivas, hey Lord, you please make us chant. It's not like that. We must give our independence to Bhagavan. Lord does not force anyone to chant. He is not going to forcibly make us do this. He has given us freedom. If we are going to give our independence to the Lord, hey Prabhu, I've given my independence at you, in your hands. And then the Lord would make us perform devotional service. So we chant the name loudly. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Chant one more time. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. There are 18,000 shlokas in Srimad Bhagavatam. We heard the important pastimes. We'll chant four shlokas, the Chatushloki Bhagavatam, and that gives us the Nanat Asatparam Pashataham Ayatidecha Yo Shishya Swasmin. Sarvada. These are four Mahapuran ki jai. Pad ki jai, Shukadev Goswami Pad ki, Shri Parikshit Ji Maharaj ki jai, ki jai. सर्व पाप प्रणाशन नाम संकीर्तन इज द एसेंस ऑफ श्रीमद् भागवतम विद द एफर्ट्स ऑफ ऑल द डिवोटीज वेरी ब्यूटिफुली दिस भागवतम वॉज अरेंज्ड What we have heard from our Shri Guru, we have heard from our Guru Parampara. I've tried to speak. I cannot speak Harikatha, but then they are our Parampara speaks Harikatha. But whatever they have spoken, I've done the Anukirtan of that. Therefore, our Gurujan, our Vaishnava Acharyas, they only want one thing from us, that is, make yourself successful and chant the name. At the lotus feet of Sri Radha Madhav, we offer our millions of obeisances at the lotus feet, whose mercy and under their guidance or at the lotus feet, we have heard their glories and we have sang and did Anukirtan for the last 7 days. If there's any fruit of that they want to give to us, we'll say that please give us Sri Guru Chandrati. May I have unflinching attachment at the lotus feet of Sri Guru. That is our desire. The moods of our Guru Parampara. May we become acquainted, understand.
Thank you. मैं कभी कर रहा नहीं ऐसे मेरे को प्रभु जी का ऐसे भी नहीं
प्रभु जी मुझे किला
प्रणाम हम लोगों ने यहाँ पर सात दिनों तक
We have been listening the different pastimes of Srimad Bhagavatam from previous 7 days. श्री कृष्ण हैज आंसर्ड सम क्वेश्चन इन श्रीमद् भागवतम
भगवान अपीयर्स एंड श्री नर नारायण दिस फोर्थ अवतार In Badrinath, the Lord is performing austerities. He appeared in Badrinath. He performed austerities as Nara Narayan. And in four shlokas, spoke Srimad Bhagavatam in four shlokas to Sri Nara Rishi. The first, Nara Narayan Rishi spoke Srimad Bhagavatam to Sri Nara Rishi in four shlokas. Maharaj just spoke those four shlokas, the Chatushloki Bhagavatam, Krite Kimva Paritishvara. Srimad Bhagavatam is being written by Mahamuni. Who is Mahamuni? So, the four shlokas were spoken by Nar Narayan Rishi, and Sri Narad Rishi spoke what he understood in essence and did kirtan of Srimad Bhagavatam in front of Srila Veda Vyasji in Shambhapras ashram nearby Saraswati river. Vyasji was not satisfied, as we heard on the first day. He wrote many other scriptures. Vyasji divided the Veda, one Rig Veda, into four Vedas. That's why his name became Veda Vyas. His name was Krishna Dvaipayan, but his name became Veda Vyas because he divided the Vedas into four parts. That's why Vyas. Vyas means to divide. And then he also wrote Upanishad. In order to understand the Vedas, a subordinate study, Upanishad was being written. Mahabharata was written. All the Puranas were written. But his mind was not satisfied. He was not completely satisfied. And at that time, in his ashram, Sri Narada Rishi, he arrived. And then when Sri Naraji arrived, how to attain para shanti, how to attain complete peace, complete happiness, complete bliss, he gave him the process. So Sri Narayan Rishi spoke this to four Kumaras and four Shlokas. Naraji spoke the same Srimad Bhagavatam, the same instruction in a much more detailed manner, gave it to Srila Vyasadeva. And Srila Vyasadeva narrated the entire Srimad Bhagavatam to his son, heard the same Srimad Bhagavatam. And then Sri Shukdev Goswami Pad spoke this to Sri Parikshit Maharaj in the assembly of Sri Parikshit Maharaj at the place is known as Shukratal, nearby on the way to Haridwar. There Sri Shukdev Goswami Pad spoke Srimad Bhagavatam to Sri Shukdev Sri Parikshitji. And then in that assembly, Sri Suta Goswami Pad was there. He also heard Srimad Bhagavatam. And then he spoke that same Srimad Bhagavatam to Shonakadi Rishi in Nemisharanyam, the 88,000 rishis nearby Lucknow on the way to Ayodhya. So when all that happened, then Srila Veda Vyas this was all in the hearing, all these are various adivation, various assemblies of Srimad Bhagavatam. But all this was in the form of hearing. But later on, Vyasadeva actually compiled it. He put it together and gave it a form of a book. Naraji perfectly spoke this to Vyasji. Through Vyasadeva came to Sri Shukdev Goswami, then to Sri Parikshitji, and then in that assembly, Sri Suta Goswami was there when Sri Shukdev Goswami Pad spoke this. When he heard whatever he heard from Sri Shukdev Goswami Pad, spoke this to Shonakadik Rishis at the beginning of this Kaliyuga at Nemisharanyam. Then Sri Veda Vyasji, he decided to give it a form of a book. Up till now, it was in the form of a hearing. It was only in form of a Shruti. Now when he gave it the form of a book, it was 18,000 shlokas. Before, there were only four shlokas. Now these four shlokas have now become 18,000 shlokas, and now we hear Srimad Bhagavatam, which was compiled by Sri Veda Vyas. Though it is not possible to speak or even hear this in 7 days, is not possible. There are many beautiful instructions and teachings in this. And if one applies those instructions in one's life, then one receives a very different kind of one goes into a very different kind of direction. Maharaji, on the very first day, he spoke the glories of Srimad Bhagavatam. Gokarna, he spoke the Srimad Bhagavatam to his brother, for his brother. For the deliverance of his brother, Gokarna speak this Srimad Bhagavatam. Dundakari received Pretiyoni, the body of a ghost. He was unable to deliver himself from that, and then his Dundakari would come to Gokarna over and over again and seek help, that please deliver me from this species. Then he went to Sri Gokarna went to Gayaji, where there is imprints of Vishnu's lotus feet. The Shraddha ceremony was done, but then even after doing the Shraddha ceremony at Gaya, Kirtan Gaya, if anyone performs Shraddha, everybody gets delivered. But Dhundakari said, hey brother, I cannot be delivered even by doing Shraddha in Gaya. I'm so sinful. Gokarna became so astonished because Gaya is a place where all the sinful people would get delivered in many scriptures and through the mouth of sadhus. That if anyone is not being delivered from the lower species, if one goes to Gaya, would get delivered after Shraddha ceremony. But at Vishnupad Peeth, because Lord actually washed his feet there, so if one performs there Shraddha ceremony, then one becomes liberated. But then Dhundakari was not liberated. It is so astonishing. So that's when Gokaranji was thinking, I'm unable to understand how to deliver my brother. So then the Suryadev himself came to him and said, hey Gokarna, your brother cannot be delivered even at Gaya. You make him hear Srimad Bhagavatam, then he will get delivered from this state. Then Gokarna, he spoke Srimad Bhagavatam, who received the body of a ghost. He made him sit in that. There was a big bamboo stick, and he invited everybody and made his brother sit in that bamboo stick. Invited everybody that I will speak Srimad Bhagavatam for 7 days, and all the pastimes of the Lord and the instructions of the Lord, there's a constant flow of Harikatha would flow. All of you please assemble here and hear Srimad Bhagavatam. Yes, Srimana Krishna Krishna Param Purushe Bhakti Udupatya Pulsam Shokmo Mubhayapaha. So that Srimad Bhagavatam which makes one free. That Srimad Bhagavatam which contains the pastimes of the Lord, which has the pastimes of his devotees. Just by hearing that, one would become free from lamentation, fear and illusion. The lamentation, fear and illusion would go away. The many sufferings which we are receiving in our life, all type of lamentation would go. In this current state, we have so much of attachment to this body. We have so many attachments to our kinship, our families. All those would get destroyed. And bhai means fear. There would be no fear in your lives. All fear would go away if you hear Srimad Bhagavatam. Therefore, everybody came to hear Srimad Bhagavatam, hearing the glories. The Krishna Param Purusha, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the one who is Swayam Bhagavan, Sri Krishna. One would develop attachment to the lotus feet of his, no matter wherever one stays. Nothing would give us any trouble. Srimana Krishna Param Purusha, Bhakti Upatte Patte Punsa Shokmo Bhaye Abha. Anyone who would listen to this Srimad Bhagavatam very carefully, one would attain the lotus feet of the Lord. One would develop attachment to the lotus feet of the Lord. So the associates of Bhagavan, they brought a wonderful, a very beautiful chariot, Dhundakari. He received a transcendental body. He got on the chariot, and Gokaranji, so when those personalities from Vaikuntha, they were taking Gokarna, then he said, hey associates of the Lord, you have brought this wonderful chariot, you are taking my brother Dhundakari, but then there are so many others who have also heard Srimad Bhagavatam here.
Why didn't you bring, why aren't you taking all of them? You should take all of them back to Godhead. Because in this world, why are you leaving them behind? There's so much a problem in the world. Why don't you take all of them back? Why are you taking only Dundakari? Then he said, then those associates of the Lord mentioned that the mood in which Dundakari heard Harikatha, other people did not have the same intensity, because he really wanted to get delivered from the material world. Others was listening, but then the mind was hovering here and there. It's the intensity. So many other people have also heard Harikatha, but then the mind was hovering here and there. Only sitting in front of a sadhu is not the only thing. One must give their mind. So our Gurudev would say, when you hear Harikatha, whatever engagement you are thinking, leave everything behind. Get free from all engagements. Forget everything that you have a room. Forget that what is inside your room. Forget that you have sisters, brothers, relatives. Forget everything. Hear Harikatha. No problem is there. With this mood, sit. Make yourself become free from all things. You are free from everything. You're not of this material world. With this mood, you should sit in front of. You have nothing to do with anyone. Who is sitting, who is not sitting, who is coming, who is going, all these things. Who is doing what? One should not be focused on that. The only thing you should focus is hearing Harikatha. Because Harikatha is flowing. What is it? What sort of instruction? What sort of message is being sent by the Lord? What is my Gurudev giving to me? At that time, pay full attention to what is being spoken. Be fully alert. So that thing which you would receive there, what you would receive in Harikatha with utmost attention cannot be compared with any gold or any other valuable thing. It would be invaluable. That invaluable mood which we would receive, and if one becomes wealthy in that, then that person becomes, then one's heart becomes filled with so much of happiness. One's whole consciousness is covered in so much of bliss. And one, if one even attains in the slightest of spiritual, then one would feel so happy, so blissful, and one would not be able to count one's blessings. That there's such a valuable thing I have received. So with such intensity when one hears this, then one would attain, then the associates of the Lord would come to deliver that person. Not just by sitting here, one would attain something for sure. It's not a waste of time. But then when we hear Harikatha or any other, we hear pastimes of Harikatha or Mahaprabhu's Harikatha, if we're just hearing for just to attain knowledge, this is not hearing. So the others did not hear Harikatha in the right mood, therefore we're not taking all of them back. So our Gurudev would often say that when you hear Harikatha, what you do? Just understand your fortune. That it's great good fortune has risen today, that I'm hearing Harikatha today. It is so rare. The whole world goes in talking about the material world like crows. Today I have been given the opportunity to speak, to hear the glories of Harikatha. Great good fortune has risen in my life. And the place where you've come, where Harikatha is going on, pay pranams. Take the dust of that place and place your head on the dust and praise. And pray to that dust, that
today this Harikatha has become, today this place has become, may this place become like the place where I attain the lotus feet. This earth, this place, may this place become merciful to me. May this place become merciful to me. And then the one who is speaking Harikatha, one would have a lot of respect, paying pranams to the lotus feet. Paying pranams that whatever Harikatha would come, these are the words of Bhagavan, and I'll keep it in my heart, and I'll give and I'll honor the words. So the one who is speaking Harikatha, that Vakta, one should honor. And these prayers with this mood, so this proper mood of in the mood of prayer, then one would become liberated. Even one is in this body, one becomes liberated. Even one is in this body, but then one becomes free from all types of entanglements, all types of sufferings, lust, greed, anger, illusion, intoxication, envy, attachment, all other entanglements, enviousness, jealousy. One becomes free from all these type of faults. Therefore, though one is in the material world, one would become free. It is like there is lotus flower in the water. So Gokaranji, after some time, he again spoke Srimad Bhagavatam. He arranged Srimad Bhagavatam again, and this time he told everybody, that all of you, that the other day you heard my conversation with the associates of Vishnu, and now this time you hear Harikatha with lot of attention, being alert, with lot of faith. Give it respect. So everybody heard Srimad Bhagavatam with a lot of faith, respect and attention. Just like along with Sri Ramchandra, all the Ayodhya Vasis went with Sri Ramchandra back to Godhead. Everybody got on the big chariot, and then everybody went back to Saket Dham. Similarly here, it's mentioned that along with Gokaran, all the other listeners, Lord himself came and gave very tight embrace to Gokaranji. He said, you have spoken Srimad Bhagavatam. You have given your full energy to speak Srimad Bhagavatam. By giving your mind, you have spoken the Srimad Bhagavatam. And you have spoken Harikatha so nicely. I'm very, very happy with you. Therefore, Bhagavan gave a very tight embrace to Gokaranji, and then he himself, along with all those who heard Srimad Bhagavatam, went back to Godhead. So in this was Srimad Bhagavatam, the glories of Srimad Bhagavatam, in a very brief manner, I have told that how should one hear Srimad Bhagavatam? When one hears Bhagavatam in the proper mood, that we can attain, we cannot even imagine what we receive. The second is, Srimad Bhagavatam taro galitam phalam ukhadam mrita drava sanyutam pibata bhagavatam samayam muhurahu rasikaha uvi bhagavukaha. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, it is mentioned that Nigam, the ripened fruit of the Nigam, all the Shastras, are meant to attain the Lord. All the Shastras explain the glories, or give us the path, how to attain the Lord. Reveals the path of knowledge, reveals the path of truth. So Srimad Bhagavatam is the ripened fruit, it's a ripened fruit of all the Vedas. So this fruit of Srimad Bhagavatam, there is no pit, there is nothing else, it's all juice. There is no skin. In fact, there is nothing which is to be rejected. Everything is to be accepted, everything is to be relished. It's full of rasa.
one should just immediately take it without even thinking, and immediately such wonderful taste, and one attains such high benefit by just accepting it instantaneously. There is an instant effect of Srimad Bhagavatam. Rasa, in general, in the material world, ras cannot stay without pit, ras cannot stay without skin. Just like mango. Mango is full of rasa. But the rasa is contained because of skin. It is there because of the pit. It's because of the actual mango and the skin. But if you take off the skin, and if you don't have a pit, then it would just become rasa. So in this way it's mentioned, the Srimad Bhagavatam rasa, Sandranand, it is very dense, it is very condensed. It's a very condensed version, just like there's a sugarcane. If one takes a sugarcane juice, and if you keep on boiling it, it becomes so condensed that similarly one becomes mystery. Similarly, the Srimad Bhagavatam, it's a condensed version of Krishna's love. So when one boils it, then that same rasa becomes so condensed. It's the rasa of Krishna's service. That Ananda is in its condensed form, just like the sugarcane juice becomes mishri. Similarly, the Lord's love for the devotees and the devotees of love for the Lord, it just keeps on coming in the heart with such high waves, and that rasa which appears in the heart and becomes more condensed, that is known as Srimad Bhagavatam. It's like a mishri. Mishri is sweet, very, very sweet. Mishri is solid from outside, you know, like rock solid. But if you place mishri in your mouth, it melts. It immediately melts. Similarly, Srimad Bhagavatam is like that. Srimad Bhagavatam is a rasa. The moods which the Lord has towards his devotees, and the devotees mood towards the Lord, when that form becomes condensed, more condensed, when it appears in the heart and it manifests, it becomes Srimad Bhagavatam. So there are many, many pastimes of the devotees in Srimad Bhagavatam. Galitam Phalam, Sri Shubhku. Until what time one should hear Srimad Bhagavatam? It is mentioned Pibad Bhagavatam, constant, all the time. One should drink this Bhagavatam through one's ears. Muraho. Pibad Rasam Alayam. It's an alay. It's the abode of rasa, that mishri, Krishna's prem, at the condensed prem of Krishna towards his devotees, and the condensed prem of the devotees towards Krishna. And the love of the gopis, the love of Mother Yashoda, the love of Nanda Maharaj towards Krishna, and for Krishna towards cows, with birds, with Yamunaji, with peacock. Krishna's prem towards his devotees, towards Radhika or towards gopis. It's filled with such prema, that condensed form. It's the abode. It's a reservoir of prema. Srimad Bhagavatam is an avatar, is a Shabda Brahma. Bhagavatam is Bhagavat Swarup. It is Bhagavan himself. The words of Srimad Bhagavatam are not different from him, because Lord is residing in Srimad Bhagavatam. And if he is performing various pastimes, it is not an ordinary book. It's not an ordinary scripture. Car. If anyone is the owner of this car, please go outside. Bhagavatam is not an ordinary literature. Up till what time one should hear is what to speak of ordinary people. Those Lord himself, he is hearing it over and over again. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the Lord's devotees, they hear it over and over again.
There's a book called Shukopal Champu, written by Shri Goswami. All the Goswamis, all the associates, they get together. Shri Radhika along with the gopis, Krishna's friends sit with his friends, Madhya Shuddha sit with all those matas who have the parental affection. Then the Maharaj sits all with all of his friends. Shri Gopal Champu, on the other hand, along the Sakhas, in the house of Nanda Maharaj, all the Sakhas, they sit together. And the Brajavasis, they get together. Purnima, Shri Vrinda Devi, Shri Lalitaji, Shri Vishakha Sakhi, everybody, they get together in such a beautiful assembly that anyone who enters Madhukand and Snigdhakand, they sing the glories of Krishna's pastimes. They sing the glories of Krishna. And everybody becomes so blissful and hears it with so much of love and affection. In fact, Bhagavatam even attracts and gives pleasure to his devotees.